Okay, let us take the first bar problem, the first example. First example, we will have our bar at x equals 0 and x equal L, and this is direction x. I will fix this point, that mean u of 0 equal to 0. And I will fix this one, but I will move it with single displacement. That means u of L equal to 1. Okay? U of L equal to 1. And I want how much force here allowed me to move this end by 1. We knew from the theory of elasticity, we knew the solution for this, F equal E times A over L, times 1, of course. We knew the solution, but we want to use this differential equation approach to compute this number, okay? So when I have the part differential equation is EA times dEtni nu of x by dx square plus p of x equal to 0. This one is equal to 0. That means d2u of x by dx square equal to 0. That means u du of x, I will integrate once, equal to constant 1. U of x, I will integrate another time, c1x plus c2. So this is the general solution for the displacement, and the values of the constant c1 and c2, I can compute it from the boundary conditions. It's very simple. I will apply boundary conditions. At x equal to 0, u of 0 equal 0. That means direct. This is 1, 0, x 0. That means c2 equal to 0 direct. And at x equal to L, u of L equal to 1. That means we have 1 equal c1 times L. That means c1 equal 1 over L. So, at the end of the day, u of x equal 1 over L times x. And actually, anybody used the finite element or something like that, he knew that this is the shape function for the bar. Okay? Okay, this is great. The strain we have here, we will write something here, additional information about the bar. The strain is epsilon of x equal du of x by dx. And the force of x equal to the strain times Ea. So it is equal Ea times the strain du of x by dx. So directly, I can get the force F of x equal to Ea times du of x by dx, which is over L, 1 over L. So this is the force. The direction of the force, by definition, I will say after that from where it comes, when we have end like this, and we have the force in this direction, it is positive, and we have end like this, and we have the force in this direction, it is also positive. These are definitions because of the normal. I will say why after that, but not that. So I want to compute the force here. I want to compute the force. So at x equal L, the force direct at L equal Ea over L, as we obtain it from the theory of elasticity. This is very simple boundary value problem. We solve it in terms of the differential equations, direct integration of the integral equation. We don't have any domain term. We don't have p of x. But now I want to give another example. We have p of x. Okay? So I will go for another example. The same example, so the second example. When we have the same bar, this is x direction. We have the same bar, and it is fixed here, and it is fixed here. Fixed means u of x, u of 0 equal to 0, and u of l equal to 0. And it is under domain load here. Under domain, constant domain load, under constant domain load equal to P. This P could be kilonewton per meter per meter. Okay? But it is in the horizontal direction. Okay? So we want to compute the reactions. We want to compute the reactions. For example, we want to compute the reaction and the displacement at the middle point. Okay? When you use a reaction, it is P times L over 2. From the two direction. This is very well known from the theory of elasticity. But we want to use the differential equation approach. Why we want to use the differential equation approach? Because I will show where is the annoying term in the differential equation. Okay? Coming back to the bar problem. So we have EA times D2U of X by DX squared plus P of X equal to 0. Now P of X is constant, equal to P. So that means D2U of X by DX squared equal minus P over EA. Integrating once, so DU of X by DX equal minus P over EA times C1. Sorry, X plus C1. Integrating twice, so U of X equal minus P over EA times X squared over 2 plus C1X plus C2. So C1 and C2 will obtain them from the boundary conditions. So at X equals 0, U of 0 equals 0. When we substitute here, we'll get C2 equals 0. And at x equal l, u of l equal 0. When we substitute, we'll have 0 equal 0. So, minus p over ea l squared over 2 plus c1 times l. That means, at the end of the day, we can say c1 equal P times L over 2 EA. Okay? When we substitute it, because C2 is equal 0, so when we substitute with X equal L, we can get it directly like this. So at the end of the day, U of X equal minus P over EA times X squared over 2 plus C1, which is P L over 2 EA times X. This is the expression for U of X at any place we want. And if we want F of X, which is equal EA times DU of X by DX, so it is equal to minus, here is U of X, as you can see, this is the expression for DU by DX, so it is minus P X over EA plus C1, and we knew C1 equal to P L over 2 EA. All of this, we have to multiply by EA, this EA. So it is minus P X plus P L over 2. This is F of X. For example, if we take at x equal to 0, that means f of 0 equal pl over 2, directly from here, pl over 2, if we return to the plus sign, we will knew it is in this direction, because this end here, okay? And at x equal l, so f of l equal minus PL over 2, we substitute here by X equal L. So we knew, because it is at this end, and it is by negative sign, so it should be in this direction. So we knew this from the theory of elasticity, straightforward. It's not a problem. Okay?